There seem to be strong parallels between the Buddhist and scientific way of perceiving and understanding reality. While these ideas are not exclusively Buddhist, but rather can be found in most ancient Eastern thought, Buddhism seems to resonate quite harmoniously with these latest scientific discoveries. I wish to illustrate these ideas by first going over three main tenets of Buddhism: emptiness, interconnectivity, and the nature of reality, and then drawing the parallels of these ideas with modern scientific understanding. To your right will be links to sources of this information, including links to videos, books, and websites. The premise of this video is the belief that these two seemingly opposite modes of perception, non-material and material, intuitive and rationalistic, spiritual and scientific, are actually two ways of understanding one reality, two sides of the same coin. A very important thing to keep in mind while watching this is that there lies a large discrepancy between how we perceive reality and how reality actually exists. Emptiness is that in which all arises and returns from. Buddha said that reality arises from emptiness, a non-dual and infinite source. For instance, the chair you're sitting on, the computer you're looking at, and even your body is arising in this moment from emptiness. To better illustrate this, think of a dream. In this dream, there's an elephant and you. So you think, this is me, and that is the elephant. They have the appearance of being two separate entities. However, when you wake up, you realize that both yourself and the elephant were both manifestations of your dreaming consciousness, the source of both this dream and an infinite variety of other possible dream worlds. Another way to picture emptiness is as the page of a book. The page of a book without words can be understood as being emptiness. While the page itself relays no message, there are an infinite variety of words, sentences, and stories that can be placed upon the page. So emptiness can be understood as a field of potential in which every possibility arises from. To begin to understand this, we'll have to redefine our understanding of material reality. We'll then find out that this emptiness, also known as the Tao in Taoism and the Brahman in Hinduism, seems to strongly parallel the concept of the quantum field within quantum physics. Let's first explore the nature of what appears to be material reality. Our reality exhibits a dualistic nature. The matter that makes up what we experience exists both as a wave or non-material entity and a particle or material entity. This waveform that particles exhibit has no definite location within space or time, but can only be understood as being everywhere all at once, spread out through the entire universe. Imagine an apple in your hand. As a particle, this apple exists within a defined location in space and time. For this example, your hand. In its waveform, this apple would not only be in your hand, but spread out through all its possible states. But how can this be? How can something that appears to be solid at the same time have the ability to be something non-solid? And how can something that appears to have a definite location in space and time also be able to exist spread out over a large region of space? As astounding as this may sound, the experiment that confirmed this has been repeated thousands of times with the same result, and what at first came as a shock to the physics community inevitably became a well-known and accepted fact. The thing that determined whether or not particles behave like waves or particles was ultimately found to be the very thing that was observing this phenomenon, human consciousness. A particle's quality is not predetermined, but defined by the very mind that's perceiving it. So what appears to be solid reality is actually just one side of two underlying aspects of reality, that of wave and that of particle. Atoms are 99 with 12 nines after the decimal point, empty space. Again, this forces us to redefine how we see both ourselves and reality. If our bodies and everything around us is mostly empty space, then why do things have the appearance and feel of being solid objects? This feeling of solidity is actually a repulsion or push of other sets of atoms, similar to how magnets will repel each other when two similar sides are put together. Our hands, feet, fingers never really touch anything, but are actually experiencing a repulsive force that gives us the illusion of solidity. Believe it or not, you're not actually physically touching the chair you're sitting in, but rather hovering right above it, as the atoms of your chair and your body repel each other. What really holds everything together and makes reality appear to be solid is a sea of fluctuating energy, not actually anything physical. Not only is your body mostly empty space, but everything you see, experience, and interact with is overwhelmingly empty space. In quantum physics, we have what's called the quantum field. This is an electromagnetic field in which all matter arises from. The particles that arise from this field are not separate, but are actually different forms of the same system. The field and the matter arising from this field are the same thing. Imagine a turbulent ocean as the field. As waves fluctuate continuously up and down, the very tips of the wave crescents are what matter and our reality arise from. The rest of the sea is out of range of perception, but still exists as potential for matter. So all matter arises and returns from this field, a field that is a continuous medium spread out through all space and time, seemingly paralleling perfectly with the idea of emptiness. From this field arises not only all the particles we perceive, but the very foundations of each and every atom that holds both ourselves and the universe together. The idea of oneness, or interconnectivity in Buddhism, is the idea that everything in the universe is intimately interconnected. The idea that we are separate entities, separate from both each other and the world around us, is considered to be an illusion. The true nature of both ourselves and our reality is that of complete unification, or oneness. Let's see how these ideas parallel with what physics is now telling us.